sees the win, and I know I'll never lose. No, I'll do it all for you, so look into the mirror.
We are set for our main event from the Horseshoe Casino Hotel here in Tunica. It is the PBC on ESPN, presented by Corona Extra. Tail of the tape for our main event is experience in edge here. Fourth straight time that Lipinets has faced a 15-plus win fighter who has three or fewer losses. Of course, he's unbeaten. CompuBox numbers show us that Castillo will throw more, but that the Russian will have more success with his accuracy and his jab. Sweet Baby Ray has the introductions.
From the Horseshoe Casino and Hotel here in Tunica, Mississippi, Premier Boxing Champions now features the main event. 10 rounds in the junior welterweight division. The three judges ringside are Rasia Allen, Keith Hughes, and Mac Thornton. And the referee in charge when the bell sounds, Bill Clancy. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He comes in wearing the red with the gray. His professional record, 26 wins, 19 of those coming by way of knockout against three losses and one bout even. Fighting out of Managua, Nicaragua. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, Walter Castillo. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in wearing the blue and the green. As a professional, he has perfect 9 bouts, 9 victories, including 7 of those by way of KO. Fighting out of Beverly Hills, California. Ladies and gentlemen, dummy gospodam, Sergey Samurai Lipinets.
Fighter in chief second. All right, guys, went through the rules in the back. I expect a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times. You must obey my commands. Your punches, here and up. Golpes, aquí bueno, debajo no. Okay? Touch gloves. Good luck, buena suerte.
Joe, did you notice?
Good luck,
did you notice right there that there was a lot of heavy Vaseline over the eyes of Castillo? That's not by accident. Scar tissue over the right eye of Castillo. He's been cut there, Joe, in his last fight, and he's been cut there 4 times in fights. Could be a problem.
5 years ago this month, he fought Luis Bentenco, and he was cut over the right eye. It opened up again in 2012. It opened up again in a fight in 2015. So watch that right eye.
Castillo, 2 of his losses, Joe, by split decision, could easily be 28-1-1 or even 29-1 if the draw that he has was converted into a win. 500, wow. 500 amateur kickboxing fights for Lipinets, and 20 pro kickboxing fights, 20 amateur boxing fights, a lot of experience. Reminds me of a fight I trained, Alexander Povetkin, Joe, also a Russian, won the heavyweight title. He had a couple hundred kickboxing fights in the amateurs, and of course he went on to win the world title.
What do you have to do to undo the kickboxing as a boxing trainer? What has to be undone and then built up?
Remind them not to kick anybody in the head.
Well, that's a good start. Not getting disqualified in a boxing ring. That's a good start.
That's pretty, you know, get in the ring with him.
But is there, well, I'll give you one.
Get in the ring with him and step on his feet.
I'd like that.
No, seriously.
Right.
Get in the ring with him and step on his feet and, you know, make sure he understands that it's upstairs that counts. And obviously Alexander Povetkin understood that.
Here's Sergey now as he's able to place that jab from a long distance out.
But you still helped, whether it's kickboxing or not. You're getting in the ring. You're getting into a danger zone. You're learning how to control your fear, how to see things when there's chaos, how to see things when it's hard to see things, when it's not clear, how to behave in an abnormal environment, in an uncomfortable environment. When you're in there 500 times, you're getting used to it. It helps you. It makes you a better fighter, obviously. I said in the fight plan that Lipinets is a slow starter. This is where Castillo, I believe he's got to make a little hay while the sun's shining. You know, while Lipinets is slow, and you can see he's
a little low there.
A little low there.
My time.
That'll kill a little
okay.
time.
It's okay. Take your time. Take your time.
The referee's okay. going to let him take up to 5 minutes if he needs it.
I would say right hand where you don't want a right hand right there.
And there's a look at it. Definitely low. And he came up underneath, and that's where you can have a problem. If it's straight on, you got that cup.
Take your
that
time.
Protector does a good job. But when it comes up underneath, could have a little problem.
Walk around.
Again, while we're taking this little break here, Castillo needs to win these early rounds, Joe. While Lipinets gives you a little opportunity while he's just slow getting out of that gate. If I'm the corner of Castillo, that was part of my preparation to my fighter. He's a slow starter, that's grabbed these first three rounds. And again, look for the spots where Lipinets sometimes will lead with a left hook in front. And when he does that, chance for Castillo maybe to get that straight right hand in. Not a bad round for Castillo.
No, not at all. Lipinets and Castillo, end of one. PBC on ESPN, a chance for us to see Sergey Lipinets, 9-0 with 7 knockouts. Not a bad first round from Walter Castillo.
No, taking advantage of information. You must use information in this world if you're going to be successful in anything you do. You have information out there, you know, apprise yourself of it. You do what I did. You look at the tape, you see the slow starter, say, oh, we're going to get out of this gate, we're going to get a lead. And then it changes the complexion of the fight, Joe, because now you got an opponent who's got to come from behind. He's got to get a little reckless, maybe make some mistakes trying to catch up.
He's got to be sitting right in the pocket that time, and you got to be careful as you saw Sergey fire back.
Yeah, again, if I'm creating the fight plan for Castillo, get in, get out. Don't stay there too long.
Scorch him in.
Because the one thing Lipinets does, he's got physical strength, and you stand in front of him too long, he can use that physical strength. You don't stand in front of him, you get in, you get out, you make him move his feet, he cannot use that physical strength the way he wants to.
Let's check in with Bernardo, who's in the corner of Walter Castillo.
Osmiri Moro Fernandez was telling Castillo, you need to be smart, you gotta go forward, be first, but more importantly, use that jab to establish the distance, because you gotta punch down the middle and not be wide with your shots.
Thank you, Bernie. Let's check in with Todd in the other corner.
Yeah, pretty interesting. Teddy, I had a question for you. Buddy McGirt was telling Lipinets, don't even worry about throwing your power hand. Don't even worry about throwing the right hand. Just the jab and the left hand to the body. Why wouldn't he want him to throw his power hand, Teddy?
Yeah, not too early, because just the same thing in baseball. We were talking baseball analogies early on. You don't try to hit a home run, Todd. You know, you let it come. You try to just do good technique, good fundamentals, and then catch the ball the right way. It's going to travel. Same thing. You look for a home run. You look for a big punch. And what happens? You hit a lot of air. You get yourself in trouble. Use the jab. Do the technical things. Do the fundamental things. The power will come. I agree with Buddy.
Interesting observation by Todd listening.
Yeah, great job by Todd.
Well, it's the new haircut that's working well for Todd. Have you seen the new haircut on Grisham?
Yeah, I try not to. But, I mean, no, it's nice. But again, same thing as the baseball. You don't try to hit home run, Joe. You try to make good contact with the ball.
There's good contact that time from Castillo.
And if it goes, it goes. Same thing in the ring. You don't look for a knockout. You use your jab. You do the things that you're supposed to do to set up a clean punch. Right now, you can see Lipinets making a little judgment. He's fainting a little bit, knocking on that front door, but not going in the front door. Give a little knock.
Mouthpiece out.
Well, that's the mouthpiece, I believe, of Castillo.
Right hand behind the jab, and now Lipinets a little more comfortable
sitting
down, firing off behind it. As we're going to get a momentary pause with 9 seconds remaining to wash off that mouthpiece and replace it.
10 segundos. Come in, Max.
Bill Clancy will put us back into action. Todd mentioned that the former trainer of the year, the former junior welterweight and welterweight world champion, Buddy McGirt, is the trainer of Sergey Lipinets. Let's listen in.
The jab is the key. The jab is the key, okay? You sure it's okay? Okay. Okay, hey. I want double jabs.
Keep up a little bit.
Okay. Okay, listen. So double jabs, putting the hook downstairs. Double jab, right hand straight. Don't loop. Straight. Step in with a double jab, straight right hand. Okay? We'll come over later. Right now, we're going to throw straight. Very good. Very good, champ. Hey, when he starts throwing crazy shots, okay, double jab him. Make him stop. Don't sit there and take those punches. Or catch and counter. Okay? They're looking for that right hand, so be careful. Okay? Very good, champ.
Buddy's up, seconds up. Teddy, you and I have known Buddy for many, many years and have broadcast many fights where he's been the trainer in the corner.
Remember when he was a world champion?
Of course, he was a phenomenal fighter. His normal cadence, his normal pace, his normal delivery is not what you just saw because of the interpreter. He has to put it out there, be measured, wait for the interpreter to do his job, pause, wait. In a strange way, can that actually be beneficial to the fighter, allowing him
to
digest and absorb the message?
Yeah, you should eat the food slowly, digest it, as you just said.
Look at Castillo coming after it.
Don't choke on it.
Yep.
You shouldn't be choking on words in the corner either. Let them come to you gradually. Agreed. Castillo has been in with the better opposition. He hopes that gives him an advantage against the undefeated Lipinets. Because Castillo comes from Nicaragua, where one of the greats came from, Joe, the late great Alexis Arguello, and of course one of the top fighters today. Some people have him on pound for pound at the top of the list, Roman Gonzalez, or better known as Chocolito.
Scucci.
So skilled, so greatly skilled, and it's great to see somebody in a lower weight class like that getting the attention and put on the pedestal that he's currently on. That was to the outside of that left guard. And now blood coming from Castillo's face.
Well, you're seeing some of the effects of the heavy-handedness of Lipinets. And you just said it, Joe.
He split his lip.
Yeah.
Castillo has a bloody mouth. But when Lipinets decides to crank it up, he is fast with those hands and heavy-handed. He brings it.
Close fight. But it reminds me, very early, but reminds me a little bit of years ago, that great fight with Meldrick Taylor and Chavez. You know, Taylor was winning the fight, you know, outspeeding, outboxing a little bit, but Chavez was doing damage. He was marking up his face, and you could see the damage accumulating, the heavier punches by Chavez. By the end of the fight, controversial stoppage, Meldrick Taylor was ahead, but at the end, you can see the damage from the punches of Chavez. You're starting to see some of that damage from Lipinets' punches, kind of like Chavez with Taylor.
There's a right hand.
Just a heavier hands. If I'm Lipinets, I'm going downstairs with a left hand and then up. I got a funny feeling he can catch Castillo standing straight up. You know, just do a little throwaway punch, maybe with the left jab downstairs, and don't even finish
seconds.
It.
Yes,
come upstairs.
Reminder, right. Go to the ESPN Boxing Facebook page or the ESPNvote.com and judge along with Teddy. It's an entertaining main event.
We got his respect with the J. keep it. Let's keep it. The jab is bunching him up. Tom, don't look for the one punch. Now, you're throwing the right hand. Start. Fourth round, Reese. Fourth round.
Buddy McGurk gets for the straight right hand, jab, straight right hand. Oh. There it is. You asked for it, you get it. The jab set it up. Here's the crooked right hand, but it works. And again, the reason it works, Lipinets goes off on the side, on the left a little bit, distracts Castillo, gets his eyes over there a little bit, and then loops that half moon up top. That's where the crooked right hand, the looping right hand, can be very effective.
Four fights in Russia, five previous fights here in the U.S., and now headlining a nationally televised main event. Sergey Lipinets in action here, the PBC on ESPN. Castillo starts off this round with an offensive attack. Landed a right hand to the head in the midst of that.
Good job by Castillo, the veteran. Just again, has to have a feel for how many is enough and how many is too many. You have time, Joe, maybe for three. Get out. If you stay there for that fourth, might be your undoing. That's how fine a line. That Castillo's walking a tightrope in his fight.
Check in with Bernardo, who's in the red corner of Castillo.
Mono Fernandez was telling Walter Castillo, I want you to have lateral movement. You've got to let your hands go, but you got to move side to side. Use that jab to control the range, but when you get a chance, work inside.
You know, I was talking about the and illustrating the looping right hand earlier. Our great fight fans at home are going to ask you a question. You guys remember Rocky Lockridge years ago back in the 80s? Joe, you probably remember Rocky Lockridge, the doofus had him.
Yep.
Main events. He made a living with that punch. He would go down low, downstairs, do a little shoe shine, and then loop that right hand up top. Lipinets likes to do that.
Some chopping shots being landed here. Body punch was the only true one to land on that exchange. Just missed with the uppercut, but tagged the belt line, did Lipinets. Now he comes surging, and there's that right hand again.
And Lipinets again, going downstairs, but in his mind, I could see it. I could see it working in his head. He's looking to set up something upstairs. Distract Castillo, get his attention down, and then go up. And again, you see the face of Castillo. Those punches gradually starting to bust him up a little. Good job negotiating distance by Lipinets right there, by just stepping out at the right distance. You know, it's subtle. You look at Lipinets, physically strong guy, you say, well, he's a seek and destroy guy. And he is, to a certain extent. But he's more than that. He's not just a walk-in, let-you-hit-me kind of guy. He's a lot smarter than that.
There's blood coming from his left eye. As they go toe-to-toe, got that belt line two times there.
Clash of heads, I think.
Yes, it was a butt, but I'll call it. I got a cut from a butt, accidental butt. I got a cut from an accidental headbutt. But.
Mike Rodriguez has work to do in the corner of Sergey Lipinets. That is a bad cut right on the left eyelid. Look at that gash. It happened in the closing moments of round number four. there was a clash of heads, and it opened up that cut. So they greased it up. Castillo did not suffer a cut that's visible to our sight lines here as they start this fourth round.
You want to go up that boxing ladder, son? A lot of things you got to overcome. Tonight, Lipinets, the undefeated fighter from Russia, is going to have to overcome that cut. It's part of fighting, part of becoming a champion.
You know, and our cut man guru, Mike Mascaro, just noted that Mike Rodriguez, who's working the corner of Sergey Lipinets, is also working the corner of Chris Areola tomorrow night down in Birmingham, about a four-hour drive away against Deontay Wilder.
He's
going to have a busy weekend, Teddy.
He's getting a little practice.
Yeah, get a little practice. Could be some blood tomorrow night as well.
Yes, sir. We'll find out how good the job Mike does.
Now, Sergey coming in strongly to the body again. Let's check in with Todd, who was with Mike Rodriguez, and check in on that cut.
Thanks, Joe. I'm here with Mike Rodriguez. What's your first concern when you see a cut on the eyelid like that?
Well, you know, it was caused by a headbutt, so they're usually a little bit bigger than normal than causing by a punch. It happened toward the end of the round. It is a pretty significant cut. I'm probably going to have to go to a dose of thrombin for this round because of the nature of the cut.
Any concern that it's deep enough that this fight could get stopped if you don't get the bleeding to stop?
Yeah, absolutely. Just by the nature of the cut, it could get a little bit bigger. Just right off the bat, it is pretty deep. It just depends on how much trauma he sustains this round. But, you know, I'm going to do my best to get it under control, and hopefully in a round or two I will be able to.
All right, Joe, plenty of science going on over here in the sweet science.
Yeah, that's right. The adrenaline coagulant thrombin. He's saying he's going to have to use, and I can tell you, Teddy, just about for fact, that's the case, because halfway through this fifth round, and it's wide open again, and blood is dripping down his face.
Yeah, if not thrombin, Avertine,
yep,
which is a cottony, white cottony substance that you put in the deeper cuts. Again, as he said, the more shallow cuts, you start with adrenaline and pressure. You know, you clean the cut out, you put the adrenaline 1-100 in there, hold it, get the blood to stop, and then you put some cold Vaseline on it. But as you said, and as Mike Rodriguez said, thrombin for the deeper cuts, either that or Avertine is going to have to be used.
And we are past four rounds. So if that cut is the reason why the fight is stopped, we would go to the scorecards for a technical decision.
Both guys, when they get in close, you know, not real careful with their heads. And there's a nice setup. Real quick, Lipinets was a Lipinet there. He leaped right in with a quick left right.
That was great the way he set up that right hand. Split the guard there, scored very well.
That cut is flowing.
Sure is.
One was late.
Teddy, watch what actually happened at the end of the fourth round. He's not bleeding on his left eye right there, correct?
Correct.
Castillo then lands this punch coming up.
Bang, right there.
And all of a sudden, you can then see blood. As Josh does a great job of a snap zoom there to see blood. They claim that that was a clash of heads that opened up the left eye. Our guys in the truck have the proof that that was actually a punch from Castillo.
Great job by the truck. And once again, why I call for instant replay usage when a fight's on TV, so you can get it right. And unfortunately, boxing doesn't do that.
Well, not everybody. Some commissions will use replay. Greg Serb up in Pennsylvania.
Oh, that's true. And he's one of the better commissions. You know, some of these guys, they need to catch up to people like Greg Serb, whether it's Vegas or whatever. But they need to catch up to guys like Serp, because really it makes no sense. It makes me bang my head against the wall to have the technology and not use it.
That cut may not matter if Lipinets keeps going like this. On the attack here in round number six. Landed a good body shot with a right hand and now patiently stalking Walter Castillo.
They're looking like wide punches, and they are a little wide from Lipinets, but he's setting them up. He's getting the right range before he throws them. And every once in a while, a little subtle dip to one side and then a punch up on the other side. Trying to get the eyes of Castillo to go to the wrong place. Now watch, Lipinets will probably go upstairs now after going downstairs.
The right hand to the body. It's how he won his last fight.
Well, he figures
body shot.
And Lipinets figures properly, Joe, that if Castillo's gonna do any good work, he's gonna need his legs. So what do? Well, you put a little, take a little air out of those tires, puncture those tires by going to the body.
Glancing blow, that right hand didn't get it clean at all.
Castillo's standing more and more in front of Lipinets, and that can't be good for him. What's really striking to me, Joe, is the punch output of Castillo has gone to nothing. I mean, he's not using the jab. I understand not standing in front of the stronger guy, but if he doesn't move his hands, Lipinets is gonna have nothing to deter him from getting more and more aggressive.
CompuBox tabulating the power punches in this round, a dominating effort, high connect percentage for Sergey Lipinets.
And again, Castillo is trying to con Lipinets a little movement, you know, doing a little Jersey Joe walkout move one way, walk the other way, but not doing enough punching, especially enough jabbing.
End of six here. Joe Tessitore, Teddy Atlas with you ringside with Todd and Bernardo in the corners, and we are commercial free the rest of the way. Gives us a chance to listen in as they deal with that cut.
Okay. We need more double jabs and straight right hands. Don't look for the knockout. Just let it go natural. Okay? Very good. Very good round. Hey, tell him to give him a lot of feints this round. A lot of feints. A lot of feints. He's going to go for everything. Hey, listen. Tell him the guy might come out crazy. Don't stand there. To box him.
You see the right hand barrage is there from Lipinets. Now we slow it down a little bit more. Now not as clean as you might think on that one, because Castillo rolled with it. This one didn't ride with it too much there.
No, there's no riding in the palm.
No. The riding was done by the punch. It rolled the chin of Castillo backwards.
Hopefully not lost in translation were the orders of Buddy McGirt, who told Lipinets, I want to see a lot of feints, saying Castillo will go for anything right here. That'll fall for anything. We'll see if he does that. Chance to check in with the corner of Walter Castillo with Bernardo.
Moto Fernandez just told him, yes, you got caught with that right hand, but now you need to take the initiative in this round. When you're punching, he's not punching. You need to go on the attack, but be intelligent. Use your range. Mark the distance with the jab and don't let him get inside.
Absolutely what I was talking about. Absolutely correct. At least in my humble estimation. You know, it's one thing to have defensive ideas, defensive answers. Castillo needs them. He needs his legs. You know, he needs to control range. He needs to avoid some of the power shots of Lipinets, but he needs to find a way to have a consistent offense to keep this strong, undefeated fighter from walking right in.
I'll tell you, Mike Rodriguez has done a good job with that cut on the left lip.
Yeah, I tell you what's done a good job. He has done a good job with the coagulant that he's put in there. But the fighter's done a good job of not getting caught on it. And quite frankly, Castillo has helped Mike Rodriguez by dropping his punch count, by not touching that cut.
Cut man's friend, a good fighter.
He has been.
In the ring.
Yeah, but the cut man's friend this time was the opponent, who's not supposed to be your friend.
Yep.
Castillo just not moving those hands. And maybe if somebody got the information, this is an interesting point, I think. If somebody got the information to Castillo's corner that, hey, you know, this was caused by a punch, and maybe you could appeal it.
Oh, good right hand there. Timed it perfectly. And now Sergey on the attack as Castillo tried to hold on. Chased back to the neutral corner.
A lot of time.
Couple body shots. Snuck in a left hand as well. 40 seconds to survive this here in round 7. A right hand to the body from Lipinets.
You see the strength being just pulled out of Castillo from the strength of Lipinets. And the point I was making is if Castillo corner knew that that punch was caused by a punch and it was probably ruled that, maybe he moves his hands a little bit more and maybe tries to stop leaving.
Look at this attack, Teddy. That's it. It's over. TKO victory, Sergey Lipinets.
Yeah, Lipinets just too strong, too aggressive. And about 2 rounds ago, we talked about it, Joe Castillo dropped his punch count way too low. Nothing to deter Lipinets from coming forward.
That's a fun fight while it lasted, and he's so heavy-handed and such a purposeful stalker. He's a TV-friendly fighter.
Yeah, he is. And he's a little bit more, again, than a catcher.
Yep.
You know, a guy that's just walking in and he's strong, he catches you or you catch him. He's got a little bit more technique to him and understanding of what boxing is about than to just walk in all the time and make himself available.
Overcame that cut, that left eyelid in round number 4. And comes here to Tunica, Mississippi and grabs the 10th win of his career, fighting a 10-rounder in just his 10th pro fight.
Hey, buddy.
He didn't have to worry about 10-rounders. Didn't even get to the end of 7.
And again, it's not going to change the outcome, obviously, but if they had gotten it right, and at the end of the day, Lipinets going to win, but if they got it right and told the corner and told everyone that Lipinets was cut by a punch, maybe Castillo goes out there on the offensive, tries to get the fight stopped on a cut, and doesn't wind up being in the situation that he's in here.
Let's go back and show you how he finished things off. And we'll show you the punch that really started it off, where he knew that this thing was going downhill and he could finish.
After you throw a jab, as Castillo did there, you're supposed to move your hand. He didn't move his head. The right hand crashed home, and then here's the end, where, you know, it's a downpour of punches. And as I said in the first fight, there's no umbrella there in the ring. And again, we'll show it to you again in case you want to see it again. And just a deluge of punches. Doesn't land clean, that one, but it backs Castillo into the ropes. The damage had been done round after round after round.
Here's Ray Flores with the official particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes 45 seconds of the 7th round. Referee in charge, Bill Clancy, waves off the bout for your winner by technical knockout and still undefeated, Sergey Samurai.